Hello everybody, now we'll discuss regarding the geometrical tolerances. In the last part we had discussed dimensional tolerances. Now we'll discuss the geometric tolerances. Basically the geometric tolerances are related to the form and the feature of the manufactured component or the components. These tolerances are given with respect to the basic size. All tolerances are referred to the basic size. They are specified to ensure the actual size of manufactured component to be well within the acceptable limits. What does it mean? What are the components are being manufactured? After manufacturing, the tolerances are geometric tolerances. Okay. Now, whether it is within the what are the form is there, it is circularity is there, flatness is there, whether it is within acceptable range is there or not, that has been decided by the geometric tolerances. For example, a shaft produced may have the diameter well within the specified limits of size, but it may not be truly a circular one. It may not be truly circular, it may be elliptical also. Therefore, what are the elliptical dimensions are acceptable? What is the minimum diameter? What is the maximum diameter? Okay, that is has to be specified. Okay, in the geometric tolerances, a keyway or slot may not be exactly perpendicular surfaces. It may be inclined surfaces. Some angle may be there. A hole produced may not have concentric diameters. Hence, it is necessary. Therefore, the permissible variation in the geometry of the form or feature of the component is called as a geometric tolerance. Now, geometric tolerances are being classified into the two broader category, that is the form variation and position variation. Now, let us see what is the form and positional variation. Form variation. Form variation is the variation of the actual form of an object, such as flatness, straightness, profile surface, etc., with that of ideal geometric form. What does it mean? What are the shape is there? Okay, what is the variation in the shape? That is the flatness, straightness, profile of the surfaces. According to the shape, what are the variations are there that are being included in the form variation? The next one is the position variation. The position variation is defined as the variation of an actual position of the form feature from the geometrically identical location with respect to the another form feature known as a datum surface. It means that what is the variation of a form surfaces or form features with respect to the datum surfaces or datum features. Now, what is this datum feature or datum surface? It is a standard surface with respect to which all dimensions are referred. Datum is the feature of the part such as the edge, surface or hole which form the basis for the datum is used as establish its location. That means it is a standard surface or it is a standard feature. Datum feature may be a point, a line or a cylindrical surface. The tolerance of a position runout is referred as a datum feature or datum surfaces. Now let us see different geometric tolerances are there. Form, profile, orientation, runout and locations are there. Now for the form type of geometric tolerances, it doesn't require any kind of datum reference. Which are those tolerances? Flatness. This is the corresponding symbol to show the flatness on the surface. Straight line, circularity and cylindricity. That is flatness, straightness, circularity and cylindricity are the form type of geometric tolerances which does not require any kind of reference or datum surfaces. Then next type is the profile. Okay. It is related to the individual features like a line profile and surface profile. Then third one, it is the orientation, runout and location which require datum surfaces. It is our relative features. which require datum surfaces or data preferences. These are orientation, runout, and location. Now, this orientation, which are the different orientation, geometric tolerances, perpendicularity, angularity, parallelism, then runouts are circular runout, total runout, locations are concentricity, position, and symmetricity. All these orientation, runout, and location require datum reference surfaces. Now, there are few terminologies are there for geometric tolerances. That is the first one, maximum material condition, minimum material condition, or least material condition, and regardless of feature sizes, RFS. MMC, LMC, RFS. Now, first of all, MMC, that is the maximum material condition. The condition in which the feature contains the maximum amount of material within the stated limits. Maximum material condition means the volume of the material is maximum. Where for minimum hole diameter, you will get a maximum material on the surface. For maximum shaft diameter, you will get a maximum material on the shaft. This is called as a MMC. Or we can say it is a maximum material condition for minimum size of hole and maximum size of shaft. Then minimum material condition or least material condition, it is a condition where the feature contains least amount of material within the stated limits. The smaller amount, less amount of material, where maximum diameter of hole and minimum diameter of shaft. Maximum diameter of hole and minimum diameter of shaft, where you will get a least material condition, less amount of material conditions. Then the last feature is that is RFS, regardless of feature sizes. This is the default condition for all geometric tolerances. No bonus tolerances are allowed and functional gauges may not be used in case of regardless of feature sizes, that is RFS. Maximum material condition, where maximum material will be available on the component. It is possible when small diameter of hole and maximum diameter of shaft is there. Least material condition, where the less amount of material is available on the final manufactured part. It is available when maximum diameter of hole and minimum diameter of shaft is possible. Let us see what are the different MMC and LMCs are available. Now see, this is the basic size of the shaft is there. Okay, it have the tolerances 2.007 and 2.003 is there. Now these are the dimensions are there. Okay, this is B1, these are the dimension. What is the LMC is there? Least material condition. Lowest small amount of volume of material will be there. That is the smallest value, that is 2.003. And MMC is 2.007. Red one shows the MMC. Then whatever the component is there, the component should fall between this blue line and red line. This is the geometric tolerance. The component should fall between this blue line and red line, that is LMC and MMC. This is called as the envelope of the size, which is represented in the form of a geometric tolerances. Then see the second example for a hole. Simultaneously for hole and shaft. Now for the shaft, this is the shaft. Okay, this blue one shows the LMC, least material condition. Red one shows the maximum material condition. For shaft, MMC is the outer diameter and LMC is the smallest diameter. For hole, it is the vice versa. For hole, minimum diameter is the MMC and maximum diameter is LMC. Let us see here. For hole, LMC is outer diameter. For shaft, it is inner diameter. MMC for hole, it is inner diameter. And for shaft, it is a maximum diameter. And portion between blue line and red line is called as envelope. Then, in another diagram, we can understand what is LMC and MMC. For whole, this is the red one is MMC and blue one is LMC. Least material condition and maximum material condition. The actual size of the feature at any cross section must lie within the size boundary between LMC and MMC for the geometric tolerances. Then see, there are some other examples are there where it will show the MMCs and LMCs. No portion of the feature may be outside a perfect form of barrier at maximum material condition. Now see here, red one is MMC and blue one is LMC. See, what are the portion, what is the object is there? Object is shown in the black color. Now see, what are the components are there? Component is entirely lying between this zone, envelope of a material. The geometric tolerance. See, in wasted portion, it shows like this. In barrel section and tapered section. In all section, it is going to lie between LMC and MMC. Depending on this, different geometric tolerances are shown on the surfaces. Now what is this geometric tolerance will be there? Now for the parallel lines. Now this is a black one. Everywhere black one is the actual shape and red one is the MMC, blue one is LMC. See, the line should fall between these two limits. For parallelism, it should fall between the two parallel circles. This is a parallel line, see is there on inclined surface. This is a parallel planes. These are two different parallel planes in inclined surfaces. Everywhere the different portions are being shown, okay, for the parallel lines in the tolerance zones are there. Now the next question is that how to indicate these geometric tolerances on the surfaces. We can say the geometric tolerances are of two form and features. Form tolerances are indicated by the symbols and the tolerance value is indicated in terms of a number or numerical value. The positional tolerances are referred to the datum features indicated by the letter symbols. That means geometric tolerance forms are represented by the symbol and number and positional tolerances are represented by the letters. Then there are three different feature control frames are available. That is for the tolerance symbol, tolerance value and datum label for which those require reference surfaces. Let us see. Now if you have seen, it will have two or three blocks will be there. First block will show the geometric symbol of that particular tolerance. Then this is a tolerance information in the second block. And in third cases, it will show the datum references. First one is the geometric symbol, then tolerance information or the value, and third one is the datum references are being shown. Now these are generally we should read from the left to right and it should be represented in the form of a rectangular blocks. Let us see one example for that. It shows the one example geometric tolerance of position, then this is a tolerance value, this is show the characteristic symbol. Phi means it is a circular one. Then M means maximum material condition. This is a primary datum, secondary datum and tertiary datum. Different datum surfaces. Now see, feature, value and datum references. It is read as the position of a feature must be within 0.003 dimensional tolerance zone at maximum material condition related to two datum surface A, B and C. This is the entire reading for the geometric tolerance. This is one more example, that is positioning tolerances, specifically value 0.003, maximum material condition, datum surface A and B, datum A with respect to the maximum material condition. It will read as the position of the feature must be within 0.003 diametrical tolerance zone at maximum material condition relative to datum surface A at maximum material condition and datum reference B. This is the entirely reading of this geometric tolerance. There are certain symbols are there which we require while representing the geometric tolerances. Circle and M means it is the maximum material condition. L, instead of this L, we can say it is the least material condition. P means it is the projected tolerance zone. Phi means it is a diametrical cylindrical tolerance zone or feature. What are you written in the rectangular bracket? It is a basic or exact or dimensions. Now datum features are represented in this form, and this is the entirely feature control frame. Three different sections will be available. Now different form feature geometric tolerances we have seen. Okay, now how to represent on the surfaces, that we'll see. For straight line, it doesn't require any type of datum surface, only two blocks will be there. Okay, first of all symbol, and the second one is value within which it should lie. Same thing is flatness symbol and the value. Flatness means 0.05, that means two flat surfaces will be differed by the 0.05. whatever the actual component will be there, that component will fall between 0.05 or 0.08, whatever may be that value. Then cylindricity or circularity. It is a circularity and this is a cylindricity. Circularity means there will be the two cylinders will be there having a gap of 0.15. Cylindricity, two parallel lines will be there between which your cylinder should fall. Then it is a profile section, then profile of a surface, then parallelism, it required atom surface, okay. Then again perpendicularity, and the last one is angularity. Then some of the positioning tolerances features are there, that is the positioning of a line, coaxiality and the symmetricity. Now some of the features require two datum surfaces, that has to be represented as shown in figure. Then with this we have completed the explanation regarding the geometric tolerances. Thank you.